Hello friends, welcome back. It's time to go for next set of C programming interview questions. This time it is going to be a pretty easy session. Maybe I will not take more than 5 to 7 minutes max. I'm going to discuss about 10-15 questions maximum, and it's about scope resolution operator. It's very simple. Instead of calling it a scope resolution operator, I can call it a scope. We are going to see about scope related questions, and it's going to be very easy. First question. You can see that I have got an int a here, and inside that I have a curly brace which has int b equal to 9. Now the curly brace is closed. Here the brace is open, here it is closed. Print b. What will be the output? It is actually not correct because the b is undeclared. Anything within the curly brace is not visible to this guy. So this guy will not see, this guy will not be able to see what is available here. So b will be totally away from view of the current statement print of this line. So answer is C, which is nothing but an error. So undeclared is the reason for it. Now see it here. Int a equal to 10. I have a curly brace open close. Int a equal to 9. Print of a. Now what will be printed? Now the scope is here. It is very much restricted. So I have a here. A is with 9, and this will not be visible here. So a is 9. Answer should be a. Now int a equal to 9, if a equal to 2, it is not equal to equal to, it is equal to 2, which means I am assigning the value. Print of a, and outside the loop I am printing a. Now what could be the output? Inside this, this value will come. Outside this, this value will come. So it should be 2 and 9 as far as, I am sorry, there is a small change. It got reinitialized. A is equal to 2. Yeah, that's the mistake that I did. Here, it is an assignment statement. That's what I told you. So, A gets assigned with 2. Hence, it becomes true. And A is 2 here. Since A got updated with 2, this 9 will also be overwritten with 2. And that's the reason we got 2 and 2 as a result. So, see that I made a mistake. This mistake should not be repeated in the interviews or in the online exams. So, this is a very, possible mistake for anybody. So, please make sure that when A is assigned with some value, that overwrites it. The basic mistake. Now, if int A equal to 9, if A less than 2, I come here, do something, and I print B. A equal to 9, A is not less than 2, hence, this line won't be executed. B is totally in trouble right now because B will not be initialized, and this will be a problem. So this won't at all come into the picture for me because the condition has failed. Hence, it will be an error. This is a straight question anybody can answer. Now, int A equal to 9, int A, if A equal to equal to 9, I am having in a bracket print of percentage D A. It is very simple again. See, I have got A here, and this A is local, and whenever I have some value without initialization, the modern compilers will have G0 assigned to it, or at times some garbage may go into it. So in that case, both of them will not be equaling to the value that we are checking for. Hence, it will have nothing done. Hence, none of the above is the answer. It won't print anything. Now here, int a equal to 9, if int a equal to 6. See that I have used int a equal to 6 inside the if. This I think I have covered already during my earlier session with if. This is wrong way of doing it. This is not correct. This will throw an error. If a equal to 6 can be done, if int a equal to 6 cannot be done. So please remember, folks, if this comes, it is right away an error. Now, I have main here, and inside main I have a equal to 9, I have fun here, and the function is called here, and here I am printing a. So what can be the output? It's very simple. Whatever variable I have here is not known to the function that is available here. Hence, it is an error. It's very simple. So the answer is C. Now here, a, I have main code here, I print a, and the a equal to 9 is above main. What do you call it? It is called as global variable. So it has access to the complete part of the code. Hence, no problem. Anything written above main can be called as global variable, and it is absolutely legal here with no problem. It is correct. Now, int a equal to 9, and then I have written the header file and the same question. This is also global variable. Since most of the compilers now does not even require this. This line is not required by most of the compilers. So this is global variable again. So the answer stays the same. My explanation remains the same. Now, I have int a here, void main, and print of percentage d a. So what is it? It is again global. By default, global variables are initialized to 0. So 0 is the answer. So please understand that there are 4 type of storage qualifiers: auto, static, extern and register. Apart from that, we have global also. You must know what would be the default value of auto, what would be the default value of storage, and when would you use register. All these things are already taught in one of my videos. I request you guys to go through it because it is such an important question for you to tackle any interview in C programming. Now next question. Int A equal to 9. It is global space. I have main here. I call the fun here. I am trying to print A. Now inside fun, I have A equal to 10. So what would be the output? It's simple. Global variable, once edited in one block, will get updated permanently. For example, here I got the global variable from A equal to 9 updated to A equal to 10. So the updated value only will be available here, and whenever I print, it will print only the updated value. Hence answer is 10. Many of us might still say that it is 9, but 9 is wrong. So please make sure you understand this basic concept. The next topic for us to discuss is about structures, which we will see a little later. Thank you for following me up. I appreciate your cooperation. Thank you.